That's good to know. It'd be terrible if your brother ate you. And I hope you have lots of fun this evening. And maybe ask your, maybe see if we can get some pictures posted. Wouldn't that be amazing? And we could hopefully see them. Remember, this is a live safari, of course, and we're celebrating Halloween out here in the African wilderness, watching these beautiful saddle-built stork. So if you'd like to ask any questions, or perhaps even just share your Halloween costumes with us, you can send those through to Twitter, and you can hashtag SafariLIVE, or you can email them, questions@wildearth.tv. Now, this saddle-built stork that we're looking at the moment, this is a male. Now, the easiest way to tell is that if you look sort of, see, when he turns his head towards us, it makes it difficult, but on the side of his face, he's got little yellow wattles. When he turns his head to the side, you'll be able to see. There we go. You can see them sort of flapping in the wind. And of course, the female, it seems as though they're off into the distance. And these birds are monogamous, very much like the other birds that we've been seeing, like the saddle-billed stork, like the hornbill. Sorry, I just wanted to turn the game drive radio off very quickly as everybody seems to be starting their drive now. And you can see that this Mr. Saddle-billed stork is just having a little preen, going ruffling through his feathers. And this is the first time that I've actually seen them here. And how lovely is that? There you go, pulled out a feather that he doesn't need. But have a look. Let's see, the waterbuck as well as the giraffe are now having a drink. Look at that. Well, no, the waterbuck is now finished. Isn't he beautiful? And of course, I always think it is quite amazing as to how these giraffes are able to bend down like that in a very vulnerable position, of course, and drink water without getting a head rash. I find that probably one of the most fascinating things out in the bush. Now, if you are a new viewer and you've never seen a giraffe do the splits before, well, here we go. And the reason why the giraffe doesn't get a head rush or the blood doesn't run to its head is because at the base of the brain, so sort of where the neck ends, there are lots of little blood vessels that sort of disperse all the blood, as well as there being a spongy muscle. So it prevents all the blood from flowing directly to the brain. And I think that's an incredible adaption that giraffe have sort of evolved as time has gone on. And I always love the way that they lick their lips after they've had a drink as well. And have you ever seen how they stand up? Maybe this giraffe does another drink. Here we go. It looks like it's going down. Now, that's when you know it's hot, when you get so many different animals down at a watering hole. Quite happy to share the same water source. Now, watch what happens, how quickly he will shoot his or bring his head back in order to try and stand up again. He's having a big drink of water. Let's see if he's gonna finish just now. They can't drink too much water. We'll hold, there we go. I love it when they do that, how they flick their heads and you see all that water sort of spraying around. I think that is usually quite beautiful. Now, I want to show you something else. Mr. Buffalo that's sitting over here is not quite comfortable with the saddle-billed stork coming so close by. Can you see it there? Oh, that one. And then there's one just to the right that is now also shifted. Can you see it there? There we go. Now, it was sitting quite happily, and as the saddle-billed stork moved and all inched a little bit closer, and that buffalo has now turned its head and sort of giving it the evil eye. And the reason why that saddle-billed stork might possibly be coming over to that buffalo, and they often do it with hippos, is because animals might be coming to their shade. But the other thing is that when the hippo, when the buffalo, when anything else moves around in the water, it starts to flush out all the fish. And of course, that saddle-billed stork will be sitting there waiting in anticipation to try and spear one of those fish. But they really eat a variety of different things. Fish to frogs to crabs to really anything, even small little terrapins. Now, Winter Prism, you've asked, you wonder if all the storks have got that little red spot on their chest. You can see it quite nicely on the male, and if I'm not mistaken, it's actually only the male saddle-billed stork that has this. I think the female lacks that patch. Now, I'm not sure, I haven't particularly noticed it on anybody else. I think that may be unique to the saddle-billed storks, but I do stand corrected. I suppose this time I'll have to page through all of the different storks and see if it is noticeable. But you really only see it on these beautiful birds though. And this is always a highlight to see with your guests. This is one of my favorite birds. Even guests or people who come and visit us that aren't particularly interested in birds, it's very, very easy to see this impressive bird and sort of sit and watch it for, I've sat and watched for an hour and a half before watching saddle-billed stork fish in a drying up pond. But isn't that just a lovely scene as well? There's a giraffe. Now that it's had a drink, it's going to go off for something to eat. I'm going to munch away for a little bit. Beautiful giraffe. Now the wind is also picking up. You can see the trees moving around quite a bit. And we've got Mr. Buffalo repositioning now. Well, actually, it looks like it's going to have a drink. There's so much action going on here. I don't know where to watch anymore. Nope. Just repositioning.